Well, Larry, many voters went to great lengths to vote yesterday. They had left work early or they woke up early, but maybe none as much as one local mom. KMBC 9's Erin Little is live tonight to explain where her story ends at St. Luke's South in labor and delivery. Erin?
Any woman who has been pregnant knows the excitement of being in labor and getting to come here, finally, to labor and delivery. Come with me. I want to introduce you to Shay, new mom, and baby Graham. He is perfect. 7 pounds, 12 ounces. Mom said delivery was just a little tough yesterday, but she has some strong willpower. She not only delivered baby Graham, but she delivered her vote on the way to the delivery room.
At 38 weeks pregnant, it was an early wake-up call yesterday for this new mom-to-be.
Realized that, okay, we have to go to the hospital now. And I looked at my husband and I said, oh, I didn't vote, and I didn't even apply for an absentee ballot. And he goes, well, our poll opened at 6. We could make it. So we did.
In labor, she headed towards the hospital, but on the way decided to make a pit stop at the polls first.
My water broke at 5:30, and so I just kind of wrapped a sweatshirt around my waist and stood in line.
Luckily, the line was short, and her last name started with a T.
Thank goodness there was no waiting for the end of the alphabet, so I got to walk right up.
After she delivered her precious vote, just hours later at St. Luke South, she delivered her precious baby boy, Graham.
He's still chugging away. Sleepy, sleepy.
He doesn't know it yet, but mom said she wanted to set a good example for her son.
I thought it would be a really cute story, too. Born on presidential election day.
And what a neat story. Little Graham will certainly have to tell. Both mom and baby are happy and healthy, and they will be going home tomorrow. Reporting live from St. Luke South, I'm meteorologist Erin Little. Back to you.
And Erin, you must tell Shay she looks absolutely gorgeous. She looks just perfect. And she says she was in labor while waiting in line to vote, but didn't tell anyone at the polls because she was afraid they wouldn't let her vote.